of you in this room have survived your own lives. How did you do it?
You're invited to a party with the irrepressible Loretta Laroche as she reveals the simple truths for living an optimistic and resilient life.
If you think the worst and get the worst, you suffer twice. If you think the best and get the worst, you only suffer once.
Join Loretta for an insightful, hilarious celebration of the human spirit when Life is Short, Wear Your Party Pants airs next. This program is made possible by the Hay Foundation, supporting nonprofit organizations throughout the world with a focus on women's and children's health and well-being, and by the contributions of public television viewers. Thank you. Loretta Laroche, author, lecturer, and renowned stress management expert, is America's favorite humor therapist. Armed with the newest findings in the mind-body field of health, Loretta has helped millions of fans take the serious to the delirious.
Hi there. Welcome. So glad you're here to celebrate the Party Pants show. Hope you're wearing them. When I was growing up, my mother would always say, "You never know. You never know." If we were having a delicious meal, she'd say, "Now wait, make sure you save something, because you never know." We would save wax paper. String. Oh, big ball of string. You had to have a lot of string because you never know. You save bits of soap, you know, tiny bits of soap. Because you never know. I'd ask her, "Well, what is it you don't know?" She said, "You'll see." So I waited to see, but I never got to know, really. We'd go out and buy patent leather shoes for Easter, but I couldn't wear them. I had to wait, because you never know. So I got to put Vaseline on them every day. Isn't that exciting? Now I put it on my face. Because it's cracking just like the shoes. It was the underpants, though, that really brought me over the edge. For some reason, I had to get sturdy underpants. Sturdy. Heavy duty, really heavy duty. Get you through a lot, you know, get you through. My mother would have a conversation with the sales clerk, and she'd say, "You know, we really want pants that last." Now, I couldn't figure this out. Was I going in a mine shaft? Maybe I wasn't coming out for a couple of months. It was very disturbing, because all my other friends had these little tiny pants, you know, with frills and bows and everything, but not me. And I begged and I begged and I begged, and I said, "Please, please, please let me out. A pair of party pants." Well, she finally bought me a couple of pairs. But she said, "You gotta save them. Cause you never know. So I put them in the drawer with my step underpants. And I would beg daily, "Can I please wear my party pants?" She said, "We'll see. You can wear them, but only on special occasions." It's interesting, isn't it? What is a special occasion? Well, I was 9 years old. I wasn't going, you know, to be a movie star. So occasionally, I got to wear my party pants. But not that often. They just stayed in the drawer and kind of molted. But, you know, the good news is that I still have them. just don't fit. Well, this might sound like a sad story, but it isn't, because there's a lot of truth to the fact that my parents and my grandparents needed to save things. They were going through a depression and World War II, and things were scarce, weren't they? There wasn't a lot of goods to be had. But you know, the one thing they had was the internal goods. Boy, did they resonate with what was going on inside of them, which was a lot of humor, a lot of joy, a lot of connection, a lot of people coming over, a lot of fun. There wasn't a day that didn't go by where people used to visit. They were called neighbors. Remember them? There was a sense of internal abundance, even though there was external scarcity. And you know, we've come a long way. There's been a huge paradigm shift, hasn't there? Boy, do we have the goods, don't we? You can shop yourself into a coma. There isn't a stinking thing you can't buy. You can have it brought over from Morocco. It can come from wherever. You can have it instantly if you want it. But we suffer from internal scarcity, don't we? We're desperately seeking to be nurtured. We walk around in our loneliness, suffering from a lot of depression, because we don't know how to access the truths, the simple truths that my grandparents had going for them. I didn't have to wait for a card to come in the mail to tell me that somebody loved me. My Aunt Ignacia would come up to me. She would squeeze my cheeks till they were bleeding and say, oh, Saporita. Now we go to the store, don't we? We don't have any time to see the people we love, so we buy them a card. Your cheeks are as white as the driven snow. Your head gives up. God gives off an amazing glow. And someday, somewhere, sometime, I may show. Love you, mother. It's kind of a sad thing that we've gotten into this place where we really do not understand the value of what life is all about. But you know, I hope in the time we're together, maybe we can sort of resonate with some simple truths, some wisdom that we all have within us that really correlates to something interesting that's happening in the field of psychology. Dr. Martin Seligman is really looking at something called positive psychology. Truths we all know, inner strengths that we have, that we really don't pay attention to because we've gotten into a situation where we're always talking about it isn't enough, and we're always sort of looking at how we have become the victim. I didn't get that because mother didn't breastfeed me enough. I'm really upset. There are over 47,000 abstracts on depression, something like 43,000 on anxiety, 407 on joy. What does that tell you? We're not looking at what we have, but what we don't. And I hope that we can really start to look at who and what we are and how we got to where we are. All of you in this room have survived your own lives. How did you do it? You didn't do it because you didn't go to the mall. You didn't do it because you didn't get enough pizza last week. There's a lot of things that have happened to you because you have inner strengths. And a lot of that inner strength comes from surviving your own life. So let's begin to look at some of these so we can all increase our ability to have an amazing life. I don't know about you, but I want an amazing life, don't you?
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, Use the link in the video description.